and the third one is called as hydrostatic bond. And the fourth one is called as the ionic bonds. And these bonds are all together called as the chemical bonds. These chemical bonds play vital role in the structural formation of proteins. So chemical bonds play vital role in the structural formation of the protein molecule. Structural formation. Now we see each bond one by one, how they are able to bond among themselves and to give rise to the structure of the protein molecules. The first one we will see about the polypeptide bond. So the first one we studied about the peptide bond. And this peptide bond, how they are connected together to form dipeptide, tripeptide and polypeptide. This helps for the linear arrangement. Or it is helpful for the so-called primary structure of the protein. Amino acid structure when we take, it has an asymmetrical carbon, single asymmetrical carbon, which is bound with hydrogen ion molecule. It has the amino group, it is attached to amino group one side. The other side the carboxylic group is present, and this side we call it as the R chain or side chain we call them. Okay. So when we, this is the structure of amino acid. When the amino acids are very present, the carboxylic group of one amino acid will combine with the amino group of another amino acid, and they are able to form this peptide bond. So now I am going to show you how this is formed here. Now another amino acid I am going to write here, the formula, HCOOH and the R chain or the side chain we call it as. So from I said one amino acid carboxyl group will bind with the amino group of another amino acid. So you can see here the structure, the bond will take place between here. The carboxyl group of the one amino acid to the amino group of the other bond. So when they are able to establish in this process, one molecule of water will be released outside. The resultant will be CHNH or side chain or R chain, we call it as, and this will CO dash NH KCH COOH and the R chain is remain. So this is called as now as the peptide chain or peptide bond. So number of them joined together, this is called as the peptide bond. So now when we take here the bonds that are taking place between amino acids, it can be of, if it understands it, one molecule of water when it is released between the carboxyl group, amino group of the amino acids, it establishes peptide bond. So now when we take here, the number of amino acids, when they combine together, they will result in the dipeptide bond. And this can go to tripeptide bond, it goes on the number. Finally, we go to the polypeptide bonds that are established. The polypeptide bonds will result in the formation of bonds, polypeptide chain of the protein molecule. So this helps the formation of, we can put one amino acid here, another amino acid here, another amino acid, another amino acid. So like that they are able to bind themselves to give rise to this polypeptide. then what joins with the here, different amino acids are here. With the amino acids, we can find the chain. Sometimes this amino acid can contain cysteine. Here we are going to take the cysteine molecules, different nitrogenous bases will be present. And this from here, this is another one containing, like this, when it comes, this also structure, another molecule of cysteine when we take. Now, in the sixth position, we can find this one can contain the sulfide group here. The sulfide group will be